Something about this song by Cutlass. It's called Take Me In. And I just love this song. I'm just going to play a little bit because I don't want YouTube to cut me off here. So here it is. Oops. To the Holy of Holies, and this I'm just going the Holy Spirit guide. So Heavenly Father, I surrender to you, Father God, I surrender my all to you, Lord. Allow me, Father God, to just be used as a vessel, Father God. Empty me, Father God, of every sin, of everything that I have done today, Father God, and just purify me, Father God, cleanse me, Father God, and wash me, Father God, with your blood, Father God, and I just ask for you to fill me up, Lord. Fill me up, Father God, with everything that you have for me, Father God. Allow me, Father God, to be used for your glory, Lord. Allow me, Father God, to be used to be of maximum service to you, Father God. Holy Spirit, guide my mouth, guide my tongue, guide my words, guide my lips, Lord God. Help me to decrease, Lord God, so that you can increase. Take control of this message and open the eyes and the ears of those listening and watching, Father God, that they may see things through a different view, through your eyes, Lord. In Jesus' mighty name, I pray. Amen. Okay, so I'm going to be reading from this prayer book. So just I pray that you stay with me. It's very powerful. Entering the presence of God. You know, some of us, you know, when we go to pray, we to enter into the Holy of Holies, you have to be patient. You can't put a time limit on the Lord. And when you enter into the Holy of Holies, there is nothing better than that place of where you are at, because you don't ever want to leave it. So with that said, how do we enter in with God? God's way. According to God's biblical pattern, in the Old Testament, our Heavenly Father set forth a pattern for the tabernacle, which he would indwell the place of worship in coming to know him. Well, today, the tabernacle indwelt with the Holy Spirit. We are that tabernacle. The place of worship is in our hearts. Most people think of worship as going to a place or building to lift hands and sing to God. True worship is an intimate relationship, an exchange with God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. This can only take place in your innermost being, a place called your heart or your spirit man. You may say to yourself, but I know how to worship already. I am continually learning and growing in God, and I say that I know is to cut myself off from continued learning with God. This also, saying that you know, it restricts or retards our growth with the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Because really, we don't know. We say we know, but there is so much more. So much more we can learn. And so deep we can go. So, according to the pattern, with God, all things are done according to pattern. Not our way, but His way. God's way is not ours, else it will fail somewhere down the line. How wonderful it is to be raptured into His awesome presence, to a place where you are not aware of time and space anymore. You will be consumed with nothing but Him. In Him, we live, move, and have our being. A friend once told me to pray before I pray. Entering in with God is not about you. It is about Him. Death to self will take place. The more you enter in with Him, the deeper you will go, and there you will be more of Him and less of you. The flesh, the worldly ways, is not allowed to go in with God and is left out. That is called death to self. In other words, the deeper you go with God, the more opportunity you will have to be changed into His image, into His likeness, and you will be less of the flesh. This is where we are putting off the old man and the old man ways, and in turn, putting on a new man, and that is with Christ, the Holy Spirit, with His character and nature. Exchange takes place, and there is His presence, and in the secret place with Him, we are transformed into Him, His image. The more you surrender to God, the more you desire to be with Him. You exchange your agenda, your life, your ways of thinking, acting, and being. And in turn, you receive, you choose to keep and walk in His life, His character, His ways, His thoughts, His peace, His order, and His timing. It is His agenda, which is called being in Him, or abiding in Him. To sum it up, you will learn to let go of anything that hinders you in this earthly existence so that you can get still before God. You know, the Bible calls us to be still. Be still and know that I am God, is what the Bible tells us. To be still, and when we are still, we are in His presence. And in this stillness, you will get to know Him. You will also learn to allow Him to position you for a deeper letting go. A true stillness before Him, deeper intimacy will occur. Realize, however, this is not a microwave experience. When you allow Him to position you, you realize that learning is about to take place. So to sum it up, you gotta let go of this earthly realm. Be still before Him and know that He is God. When you are still, you are being intimate with God. The intimacy with God starts here. A life-giving exchange in getting to know Him. So then, at this point, in prayer, I sing a song which echoes the longing and heartfelt desire to be with God. You begin to worship. You begin to sing. You sing praises to the Lord. You will be drawn through the veils that separate you from God. Along the way, with the Holy Spirit, during this time with the Lord, these hindrances, veils, and their effects should tremendously decrease. You will start becoming more aware that you are coming before a great and all-powerful God who loves you. Struggles will pursue you. Struggles will pursue and try to entangle you as you go further into God's presence. And I'm sure you have experienced that before. The more you try to focus on the Lord and go deeper into His presence, the more distractions and sounds you will hear, or knocks on the door will come, because the enemy doesn't want you to get into that place, into the Holy of Holies. The enemy doesn't want you to commune with God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. They will try to keep you or draw you out, but there are some easy techniques I will share with you that He wants you to learn so you can continue on in this time with Him. All the time you are in prayer, you will be developing and growing in Him and should become more dependent upon Him. Remember this, God wants you there with Him too. God, He longs for you to be there. He desires you to be there more than you, believe it or not. So, here is the journey. A few steps to a successful and joyful time with God. At first, I strongly suggest that you have a prayer closet. This is a place where you can go and you will not be disturbed. My prayer closet is... Okay, I'm not going to just continue here. Okay, you will not be disturbed. If God called you to get with Him, He comes first. So, okay. The first things first, on this side of the veil is the earthly realm. When you are clean, or you have prayed, and you are cleansed of sin, strongholds, bondages, demonic spirits, curses, evil or wrong prayers, assignments coming against you, unrighteous agreements have been destroyed, controlling prayers, instruments of unrighteousness driven out, evil principalities, powers and rulers in high places, severed from you. You have been cleansed by the blood and have the armor of God on. You are protected by the blood. Then you are ready to begin to approach the Lord Jesus Christ, our Heavenly Father. Personally, I ask the Lord, according to John 14:14, to loose His angels around me and to keep out all demonic spirits from coming anywhere near me, the house or the land, as the last thing I do before entering in with Him. You are now ready to start a walk with the Holy Spirit, which will lead you into the holy place to meet with our Messiah. And then from there, to the Holy of Holies, to be with our Heavenly Father. So, now first we need to confess our sins and we need to repent and ask for forgiveness. You see, every day we should want to enter into the Holy of Holies, which means every day we should confess our sins and repent. Some people say, you know, you don't need to repent that many times, or, you know, because, listen, no, we are to repent every day, because every day we will sin in some way, in some form, some shape, some type of sin without even realizing it, because we live in this earthly realm. We live here. We live in the flesh. You know, so it's going to happen. So before we enter into the Holy of Holies, we confess our sins, we repent, and ask the Lord for forgiveness. Continue to get cleaned up, as I mentioned, in this section of the earthly realm. We will enter in His gates with thanksgiving. The atmosphere spiritually clears, and we are ready to center our hearts deeper on the Lord by praising Him and worshiping Him. We will enter His courts with praise, and we will enter the holy place. The Holy Spirit, where the candlesticks of light or illumination is, the Holy Spirit bringing knowledge, wisdom, revelation, and understanding, He is the light of men and women. Where the altar of incense is, true worship and exchange and a deeper intimacy occurs in this place with Him. Prayers of the heart arise as He places them on your heart. So this is saying God will put certain people into your mind during this time, and He is asking you to intercede for them. So intercession may occur here, and we will enter into the Holy of Holies. Be obedient to what the Lord, to what the Holy Spirit leads you and calls you to do. There is a transition that occurs, a transferring into the Holy of Holies. This is the place we meet our Heavenly Father. This is the time when we are drawn into God's presence. You don't just go in of your own accord. God the Father draws you in past the veils of the flesh, mind, emotions, distractions, hindrances, things, cares, riches, and pleasures of this world. You are coming into the presence of an awesome and to be feared, reverence God. It's time to go there. After praying and getting cleaned up and asking the Lord to loose angels around you and in the house, it is time to enter in. Start out asking the Holy Spirit. Pray to the Lord in heaven. Lead me and guide me into the holy place. And then into the Holy of Holies. You can say this. In the name of Jesus, I command my spirit, mind, will, my emotions, ego, libido, imaginations, subconscious areas, the mind of the flesh, and all areas of my life, down to the obedience of Christ within me. Prayers for entering in. Holy Spirit, I ask you to pray to the Lord in heaven to remove me from any hindrances and obstacles and double-mindedness duplicity in anything in my life or on the throne of my life that may not belong. Holy Spirit, I ask you to pray to the Lord in heaven if there is anything in my life or any area in my life that has not totally submitted to the mind of Christ. I give you permission and ask you to cause these areas and or these things to come down now to the obedience of the mind of Christ within me. In Jesus Christ's holy name. Now, around this time, if you have the gift of speaking in tongues, it should manifest, and you know, you'll be either speaking and praying in tongues. And then, Holy Spirit, I ask you to pray to the Lord in heaven that the mind of Christ arise in me over all areas of my life and over the throne of my life. Holy Spirit, I ask you to pray to the Lord in heaven to remove anything that would hinder me from coming into total oneness and completeness and knowing you and having an intimate exchange with my Heavenly Father, the Son, and you, the Holy Spirit. From where I am now with you and through the time you want me to have in the Holy of Holies. Amen. And then continue speaking and praying in tongues, being led by the Spirit, if you have that gift. So once you do all this, you are able to enter into the Holy of Holies. You'll enter in his gates with thanksgiving and praise in your hearts. By now, God's presence should be evident. His presence may be felt. You may experience his presence as a light tingling or as a strong anointing throughout your body or in an area of your body. If not, if you don't feel these things, then ask him. Say, Heavenly Father, I ask you to cover me, to cover us. Heavenly Father, I ask you to fill this room with your presence. Start off saying that. Heavenly Father, I ask you to fill this room with your presence. Or Heavenly Father, I ask you to cover me with your presence. Holy Spirit, I ask you to pray to the Lord in heaven to take me now into the holy place. If you have the gift of tongues, this is also a good time to pray in tongues. You see, the Holy Spirit is our helper, but the Holy Spirit is also God. So, this is when you meet with the Lord Jesus Christ. Holy Spirit, I ask you to pray to the Lord in heaven and cause me to hear and know my Lord's voice. I speak aloud, saying, Lord Jesus, you are the bread of life, the life and the light of men. And then you be quiet. Be quiet and listen. Be still and do not talk. You might hear your name be spoken, and he will respond to you. He speaks, identifying himself as I am. Just listen and be quiet and listen to what he tells you. You may say, I am that I am, or you are, and then you can speak back to him, you are the I am. So during this time, just be still and know that he is God. And just ask the Holy Spirit to continue to help you to reach and speak to the Father. And then you will hear him. And you will know that it is him because of his voice. You will know that you know because you will know because your inner man. Your inner man, it is him because Jesus lives within you. His peace will fill you up when he speaks. He will tell you he loves you, and he wants you to know that he loves you. Sometimes he will say, I am the great I am, the creator of heaven and earth, the creator of all things. Then thank him. Thank you, Lord. Yes, Lord, the peace of God will flood your entire being when you are with him. You will feel so peaceful that you will never want to leave it. You will never want to leave that place that you are at. And so you just start praising the Lord and you just start thanking God. And then you start worshiping him more. And your worship will get deeper. And you will start praise and your adoration, you know, will just increase so much more. And here is another time of transitioning. You're transitioning more out of the flesh and being positioned by the Holy Spirit to be taken into the Holy of Holies. Notice I said taken into the Holy of Holies, because we cannot just enter it on our own. We have to be taken, basically invited through our worship in our time with God. That's why I tell you, and not just me, but many other people say you cannot put a time limit on God, that you must take time out to worship him, to get to know him, to seek him with all of your being. And so when you take time out like this to seek him with all of your being, you will hear from him. If you're not hearing from him, you're not being completely still. You're not really, you're wanting a quick result. You want to hear it fast, you know, because that's the world that we live in. But God is patient. He is long-suffering, therefore, with us, his children, he will test us and you know, see if we are long-suffering too, if we are patient. Because if we are patient and we will be still, we will hear from the Lord through our inner being, through our inner man. So, is trouble still keeping your mind from entering into the Holy of Holies? While listening to either the Father or the Son or the Holy Spirit, it is important to focus on his voice. Again, you can pray using any of the B techniques as follows. Holy Spirit, I ask you to pray to my Lord in heaven and quicken me. Cause me to hear and know the Lord's voice or my Heavenly Father's voice. Or you can say, Say the name of Jesus. 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 Just continue to repeat the name of Jesus. Speak under your breath because it might distract other people in the room. And then you can also say, Holy Spirit, I ask you to pray to my Lord in heaven. Quicken me back to where I was with the Lord Jesus Christ. Cause me to hear his voice, not a strange voice. And then you can speak in tongues again. Holy Spirit, I ask you to pray to the Lord in heaven to quicken me back to where I was with my Heavenly Father so I can hear his voice and not a strange voice. In the name of Jesus Christ, I command my mind, will, emotions, ego, libido, imaginations, subconscious areas, thoughts, brain, physical being, all that I am, down to the obedience of Christ within me. And I ask you, Holy Spirit, that the mind of Christ arise over all areas of my life. And even if you want to or feel led to, put your hands on your head. And, you know, pray over yourself whenever you say this. I do it all the time. Heavenly Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, I give you permission and I ask you to cause all areas of my life to be totally subject to you. And ask you to bring all those things in my life down to total obedience to Christ within me. I give you total permission, 100% of all that I am. I ask you to deal with all things in me as you will. And then speak in tongues again. Then be quiet. And listen, and he will speak. Usually, the Lord will purify me in his light. You will just feel the brightness, the rays of God shining his face upon your face, upon your heart, and upon your soul. You will feel his light. His light will wash over me. And then changes are being made in us as we yield and turn ourselves over to him. We are being made more like him. So do not even concern yourself with what is going on or happening around you. During that process, just know it is for the better, for his and ours. Know him and trust him. You have to realize how very important you are to him and how much he incredibly loves you. It is to be an uninterrupted, intimate time together, giving full attention to him as he does with you. Through more trips into the Holy of Holies, he will take you into deeper levels of being still before him. Deeper times of exchange and a deeper getting to know him. Your entire mind, spirit, and body will be affected. You will never, never, never be the same. you will incredibly... It is so incredibly wonderful that you will desire and covet that time you spend with him. Nothing else will satisfy like being in him. We have to learn to be patient with ourselves, to wait, call upon the name of the Lord. You are a work in progress, and you can't do this yourself. We need to see that we need him. We are his tabernacle, his building, being built up in a holy way in him. Your spirit man will know when it's time to leave the Holy of Holies. You will hear God tell you to go. And when you are in his presence, you don't want to leave his presence. But you don't have to. You can carry him with you. And then, don't be eager to jump back into the things that into the things of this world, you know. Take your time, because you just entered in such a place of ecstasy with the Lord. Such a place of peace and of love and of light and of power. See, God truly wants this. He wants us to enjoy and to rest and to soak this in. He wants to enjoy the journey, to dwell on the things that are good and pure, because they are from above. A religion is a man's effort and ways to reach God. Religion was never God's way or plan. Relationship with him is, and you get relationship by praying, by spending time with the Lord and not putting a time limit on God. And that's all that I have. I'm sorry, this is very long, but I'm going to try to crop some stuff out and, you know, shorten it a little bit. But for those who are interested into what the Lord has to say, because I'm just a vessel being used, it is a blessing to be used, that God is able to use me. You know, many people say that they don't hear from the Lord. Well, maybe they're not doing something the right way. Because we have to come to the Lord pure and cleansed. And we have to spend time. Put no limit on God. Just be still, focus. If you are able to have time alone and to get away, that is the time to seek the Lord and not put a limit on God. He knows what you have to do. He knows that you're busy. He knows that you have family and dinner to cook and errands to run. And I mean, he knows it all. You know, and he enjoys it. He enjoys watching you interact with your family. Watching you take your daughters and your sons to baseball games and to sports, and you know, he enjoys all of that, because that is what is important. Family and love, you know, affection, being there for one another, others, you know. But also we need to make sure that we're not putting others before him, that we are not putting work before him, that we are not putting ourselves and our selfish desires and pleasures before Him. In all things, He should come first. He should be in our conversations every day. We should say His name and talk about Jesus to at least 3 people. So, and everything that you hear, I pray that this video blessed you, and I pray that you will really listen to what the Lord, I'm not even taking any recognition of this video, because this, I prayed about it, and I asked God what He wanted me to make a video on, and what He wanted me to do, because there's so many people out there who claim to say that they pray and that they just don't hear from God. Maybe you're not spending enough time being still, being patient. Because right when the Lord goes to speak, people give up and they walk away. And they miss out on something so wonderful that really it's right there in your hand, that gift, it's right there that He wants to give you, that relationship, that intimacy He desires with each and every person. You know, He doesn't favor anybody. You know, He loves us all equally. But do you love Him more than you love your spouse, more than you love your children? Do you put Him first, or do you put your family first? Sometimes you can even put your ministry first instead of your relationship with God. So, I'm going to leave you with that. I pray that you, that this will help you. And I love you. And I will talk to you later. Good night. Bye-bye.